Well, it's that time again. It's Halloween here on Art Nouveau with your host, Leilani Joy. And I have a very exciting costume tutorial for you guys this year. This year, I will be taking on the amazing, butt-kicking, super cute, awesome Ramona Flowers.
Well, then Gideon best get his pretentious ass up here because I'm about to kick yours out of the Great White North. Gideon in a thousand pieces, you slag!
Quick announcement before we get started. All the supplies used in this tutorial are listed in the video description below and at the end of the video, including the sources. So please don't message me about asking where to buy these things because I already listed them all out for you and provided links. So I already did all the hard work for you, so please don't email me for that. For this costume, you will need the following. A wig cap, a wavy blue wig, scissors, black acrylic ink, 70% alcohol, a spray bottle, latex gloves, a comb, a green army-style dress, teal fingerless gloves, a black studded belt, a magenta striped top, turquoise fabric, or you can cut the sleeve of a turquoise top and sew the end to your striped top to get the turquoise cuff. Sheer black tights, a subspace bag, brown lace-up combat boots, thin black elastic for the necklace, some natural false eyelashes, red lipstick, and finally some metallic turquoise nail polish. Last but certainly not least, we'll need to make Ramona's giant sledgehammer, plus two against girls. For this, you will need a wooden broom handle or stick, thin sheets of styrofoam that's flexible, foam core board, a sharp knife or X-Acto blade, lots of duct tape, a hot glue gun and glue, black spray paint, a silver hammer finish spray paint, and a tan or wood colored spray paint. You will also need something to serve as the topper of your hammer. I'm using a shaving cream lid. And if you want to get really accurate, you're also going to need some twine and a jingle bell. Now lastly, I wanted something strong that could serve as a support for the top of my hammer. And looking around the house, I found a tub of red vines, and I thought this plastic lid would make the perfect base for my hammer.
Hey, Ramona.
Hey. What the hell?
So perhaps the most important element to Ramona's look is her distinctive hairstyle. So you're going to start with your long wavy blue wig. So start by keeping some of the long pieces in the front to make sure you don't trim those off. And then you're going to cut the bulk of the hair off so you can kind of start styling it from there. It really helps to have several photo references as you work, and work slowly and carefully because, as you know, a wig is not going to grow back. So before going too short with the wig, you're going to want to try it on and start sort of styling it while you're wearing it, because you can get a much better idea of whether or not it looks correct. Continue cutting off just a little bit at a time until you're happy with the look. Once the style's finished, then we're going to start dyeing. So you probably noticed that Ramona's hair is actually not solid blue. It's black underneath and black underneath her bangs. So next, I'm going to be dyeing my wig. Okay, you guys, so after you've cut and styled your Ramona wig, the next step is to actually dye the wig. And this is going to be my first attempt ever at dyeing a synthetic wig, so hopefully this will all turn out all right. I'd like to thank Tips for Tat for her YouTube tutorial on how to dye a wig, and I'm going to be using her step-by-step process in attempting this. So you will have the things that I listed earlier, your spray bottle, ink, the rubbing alcohol, and you're also going to need a hair dryer with a low setting since you're going to be drying lightly as you go along so the ink doesn't bleed. According to Tat, she uses 1 cup of alcohol per 7 or 8 drops of ink. So since my bottle's a little small, it's only 6 ounces, which there's 8 ounces in a cup, I'm going to be using probably about 6 or 7 drops of ink depending on the consistency of it. So I've got some paper towels, I got my rubber gloves, and some courage. So let's try and dye this wig.
1, 2, 3, 4!
once you finish dyeing, let your wig dry for a couple of days. Then you're going to rinse it with cold water until the water runs clear and you get all the ink out of it. Once that's done, you can either dry it lightly on a low setting with a hairdryer or let it dry for a couple of days before wearing it. Okay, now for the fun part. Now we're going to build this hammer. You're going to cut out all the following pieces from your foam core and styrofoam, starting with the base panel, which is cut from the foam core board and will be 11 inches wide by 8.5 inches tall with a hole in the center. Next, cut a front and back panel from the styrofoam that is 11 inches wide by 8 inches tall and 10.5 inches to the top of the curve. Make sure you cut two of these and that they're exactly the same. Next, you're going to cut two side panels that are 7.5 inches by 8 inches tall. The top panel will be 18 inches wide by 8.5 inches tall. Now this is very important that you're using the thin, flexible sheets of styrofoam because you're actually going to bend this piece into a curve at the top of the hammer. Finally, you're going to cut three trapezoid shapes that are 8 inches wide at the top, 8.5 inches tall, and 7 inches at the bottom. These will be used as supports inside the hammer to keep it sturdy. Once finished cutting, all your pieces should look like this. Now I suggest setting up your broom handle between two chairs and keeping it upright so that you can work on it. First, you're going to glue the base to the top of the broom handle and secure it on with some duct tape to keep it from sliding off the end. Secure some duct tape underneath as well to keep it from moving. Next, drill a hole in your plastic top or other support and glue it in place with hot glue. Once the glue is dry, you should have a nice sturdy base for your hammer. Next, I'm going to spray paint the base and the plastic container lid with brown spray paint so it matches the wood handle. While you let your spray paint dry for at least 15 to 20 minutes, you can start by covering all your styrofoam panels with duct tape. This will reinforce them, keep them strong, and allow you to hot glue them without melting the styrofoam. Cover each piece so that all of them look like this, and then we can start assembling the hammer. Start by hot gluing the front panel to your base panel, then securing the seams with duct tape on the outside and the inside to keep them extra strong. Then you can do the other panel and then fit the side panels. Remember to reinforce them on the inside and put some extra hot glue just in case. Finally, put in the support pieces and glue or tape them as well. With most of the hammer together, now we're going to add the top panel. You can gently bend or flex the styrofoam until it fits nice and neat into the top of the hammer. Use hot glue and then secure with more duct tape until you have a nice, smooth edge. Now before we add the spray paint, you're going to mask off the base.
All safety precautions in place, let's paint.
Paint on a nice even coat of your black matte spray paint and allow to dry. Then you're going to take your hammered finished silver spray paint and highlight all the edges of the hammer. This will make it look more realistic and more like the one in the movie. Once it's dry and finished, you're going to apply the final touch, which is the shaving cream cap that I've also spray painted tan. To polish it off, tie on your jingle bell with the twine on the end of the handle, and your hammer is ready for battle. Now, if I could only figure out how to fit it in my subspace bag. Now, Ramona's makeup is pretty simple and natural, except for her red lips and her long eyelashes. So I'm going to keep my makeup pretty simple, use a natural eyeshadow, do a little eyeliner, and then apply the fake eyelashes that I showed you earlier.
Hello again, friend of a friend. I knew you when our common goal was waiting for the world to end. Now that the truth is just a rule that you confess.
Okay, makeup's done. It's time to suit up.
Here we go! We'll be right back. show you the sights you know you wanna ride. I'm a garbage truck. Truck, truck, truck. Well, there's the mansions by.
That's it for my Ramona Flowers costume tutorial. I hope you guys had a lot of fun along the way. I know I did. Please subscribe if you liked this video, and don't forget to check out my other videos for my art tutorials and other fun stuff. Please check out my website, leilanijoy.com, for all my artwork, one piece in particular featuring a portrait that I did of Ramona. You can find prints of her and other goodies in my Etsy shop right here, and please become my fan on Facebook and Twitter for updates on new artwork, videos, and everything else I'm working on. So with all that said, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. So, bye, and stuff.